saw Lil Rayford one day walking the streets of Palmetto, walking down old Dusty Road. And all the trouble that Lil Rayford was going to get in. I can talk about myself. He knew one day Lil Rayford was going to grow up and he was going to drink with the family. He knew that one day Lil Rayford was going to grow up and he was going to start smoking the funny cigarette. He knew that one day Lil Rayford was going to grow up and commit all kinds of sins. So he started making preparation for Lil Rayford to get back in the connecting chain with him. And I heard somebody say one day between Malachi and Matthew, the Bible said that it was 400 years of silence. And heaven had a meeting. And they tell me that God sat at one side of the table. Jesus was on the other side of the table. Grace and mercy was on one side. And time and justice sat on the other side. Time looked down and said, man has been given enough time. I wonder, can I get a witness? And I don't hear anybody praying no more. They're not even sending sacrifices up to you no more. And I feel that man ought to be given justice for all the bad things that he's done in his life. I wonder, can I get a witness now? But I heard Tom say, well, I don't see it like that. What do you have to say about it? Grace said, well, I feel that man ought to be given just a little mercy. Mercy for everything that he's done in his life. Mercy for all of his wrongdoing. Mercy for all of his backsliding ways. And I heard him say, well, what do you have to say about it, Jesus? Jesus looked in the face of the Father and saw the displeasure in the face of the Father. And he said, burn offerings and sacrifices for sin thou hast had no pleasure. But if you just prepare me a body, I'll go down and do what the goats and the lambs can't do. I'll do what the sheep and the burnt offering can't do. I'll go down in the form of mankind. And I'll let man know that he can walk in the world and not be of the world. I'll let man know that there's somebody in love with him. Don't fool yourself. You are not hated by everybody. Somebody loves you. And his name is Jesus. Somebody said he's married, baby. He got in the wheel. Ezekiel said, I saw it. There's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. Jeremiah caught the Holy Ghost and said, it felt like fire. Get up in my bones. I wonder, can I get a witness this morning? Somebody went to the meeting one night and they found out something. And if I get down on my knees and I call on the name of Jesus, he'll come and see about me. Jesus, Mary's baby. Jesus, peeking on the lamb. I fought him for myself. Mama's Holy Ghost just wasn't good enough. Daddy's Holy Ghost couldn't save me, but I had to try him for myself. I went to the meeting, sat on the mourner's meeting. Didn't nothing happen Monday night. I told y'all about it a few Sundays ago. When I came on back Tuesday, didn't nothing happen Tuesday night. Came on back Wednesday, didn't nothing happen Wednesday night. Something happened Thursday. During the day, God put a song in my heart, put some running in my feet. I came back to the meeting that Friday evening. I couldn't sit still. Holy Ghost came all over me. few minutes ago. Jesus came down 42 generations, walked among men, opened up blinded eyes, healed sick folks, gave sight to the blind. But ultimately he came to lay down his life. He said, no man take my life, but I'll lay it down. And if I've got the power to lay it down, I've got the power to pick it up again. They tell me they hung him there, nailed his feet to the cross. That wasn't good enough. They nailed his left hand to the cross. That wasn't good enough for him. They nailed his right hand. But they forgot the prophecy. While they were doing all of that nailing, he was laying down on the ground. But I heard Jesus say in his prophecy, go ahead, nail my feet. A thief on the other side. One thief said to him, if thou be the Son of God, come on down off the cross. Save yourself and save us. But the other thief looked at him and said, we are being justly served of the things that we've done. But this man has done nobody wrong. Say, when they were taking him from judgment hall to judgment hall, Pilate say, go bring me some water and let me wash my hand. I don't want to be guilty of killing an innocent man. But what he didn't realize, that Jesus, the Son of God, God in the flesh, could have came down anytime. But Jesus said, I came here for one purpose. Just like when people look at you and think you're going down for the last time, I heard old Satan say, let's get ready to party. When they put him in Joseph's tomb, when he gave up the ghost, Satan said, it's party time now. I heard him say, just like they say about you, when they see you house in foreclosure, when they see your car getting repossessed, and they start laughing at you. But tell somebody, I'm coming through this. It ain't gonna be like this always. Jesus went down in the grave, wrestled with that old death angel. I heard him say, wait a minute, I've gotta go in the days of Noah. I've gotta preach deliverance to those. I've gotta preach it to them that have been dead for a while. But I heard him say, by the time the third day rolled around, wait a minute, I've got some unfinished business. Because if I stay out here any bit longer, my prophecy can't be fulfilled. Because I told them that you can destroy this temple, but in 3 days, I'll make it up again. But Jesus allowed the prophecy. It's time to go now. And he stepped out of that grave after 3 days. All power in his hand. Not just some power. All power is in his hand. And he told the disciples, go tell the men to meet me in Galilee. I wonder, can I get a witness? He said, it's expedient for you that I go away. Because if I go away, I'm going to send you another comforter. I heard somebody say that on the day of Pentecost, they were all in one place and on one accord. And the Bible said that the Spirit of the Lord moved upon them, and they spoke with others.
scripture says that after the Holy Ghost come, then ye shall receive power. Walking right power. Acting right power. Living right power. Loving right power. I've got power over my enemies. I've got power over the devil. I've got power. It's only a test,
yes,
of the emergency broadcast system.
Yes,
and I heard Jesus say that all you got to do is take the test.
Yes.
Don't try to be exempt from the test.
Yes,
take the test because you already victorious.
Yes,
take the test. Don't try to push it away from you.
Yes,
it's your test to take. It's only a test.
Yes, sir.